So, time for the next topic. The next topic is the next Opamp application, which is Opamp as a subtractor. So, what is a subtractor? The subtractor is the one which finds the difference. So, for you to find the difference, you will need basically two inputs, yes or no? So, now I have considered two inputs. One is V1 and the second is minus V2. You will understand the reason behind me taking the value of second input as minus V2 in the later stages. All that is because we want to find the application of an opamp as a subtractor. That is why we have chosen this minus V2. You will understand it. So now, V1 is the voltage applied across R1 resistance, across which the current flowing is I1. So next is minus V2 is the voltage applied across the resistance R2, across which current flowing is I2. The feedback resistance is Rf, across which the current flowing is If. Yes or no? So now, however, there are two potentials what we have considered here. So the inputs, both the inputs are being given to which terminal? It is inverting terminal. As we have given to inverting terminal, it's quite obvious that the non-inverting terminal has to be given to ground. If non-inverting terminal is given to ground, this VB potential is equal to, VB potential is 0, yes or no? So next is, because of virtual ground, VA is equal to VB. If VA is equal to VB and VB is however 0, so VA is equal to VB is equal to 0, yes or no? So as VA is equal to VB is equal to 0, now let us try to find the other parameters. So here, are you able to notice this point? This point is the one where both of the currents are meeting. Yes or no, both the inputs I1 and I2 are meeting at this particular point and are flowing through this path. Because of which, we know that the current I1 plus I2 can be equalized to the value for IF, because all of them are same currents, or both of these are same currents. The first current is I1 plus I2 and the second current is IF. Both of these are equalized. Now let me try to find out the value for I1. What is the value for I1? I1 is situated between two potentials, which is first one is V1, second is VA across the resistance R1. So what is I1 is equal to? I1 is equal to V1 minus VA upon R1. It is written here. And VA value, we know that is 0. That is why I1 is equal to V1 upon R1. Next is, what is I2 is equal to? I2 is equal to minus of V2 minus VA upon R2. So it is minus of V2 minus VA upon R2. VA is equal to 0. That is why it is minus V2 upon R2. Next is the value for IF. What is value for IF? IF is situated between two voltages. One is VA, second is V0 across the resistance RF. So it is VA minus V0 upon RF. VA value is 0. If VA value is 0, the answer is minus V0 upon RF. Now, we are supposed to put all of these values of I1, I2 and IF in the equation for IF is equal to I1 plus I2. When we substitute, we get the values minus V0 upon RF is equal to V1 upon R1 minus V2 upon R2. Correct. So the, however, the formula is IF is equal to I1 plus I2. What is IF value? IF value is minus V0 upon RF. I1 value is V1 upon R1, and I2 value is minus V2 upon R2. That is why the formula has become minus V0 upon RF is equal to V1 upon R1 minus V2 upon R2, right? So now this RF, let us take inside along with the negative sign. So V0 is equal to minus RF upon R1 into V1 plus RF upon R2 into V2. This has become plus because minus into minus, or minus into minus is plus. Next is V0 is equal to RF upon R1 into V1 plus RF upon R2 into V2. Now if we assume all of these resistance are equal, then this gets cancelled and this gets cancelled. You'll be left with V0 is equal to minus V1 plus V2, which can be written as V0 is equal to V2 minus V1. This minus sign in between the inputs indicate that output value is the difference between the two inputs. So V0 is equal to V2 minus V1.